Hi guys, welcome back to ChargerLAB. Power strip is something we need to use in our daily life. Usually, we need a charger to plug it into the socket and use the charger to charge our devices. But recently, more and more power strips have integrated the charger module inside, so you can skip the charger to charge your devices directly. And here is what we're gonna tear down, the power strip made by UGREEN with two 65W USB-C ports. Let's directly open it. Just the warranty card and manuals. And here it is. The UGREEN is engraved on the plug. It supports 10A 250V. It doesn't adopt a strip shape, but it's more like a cube. So you can also call it power cube. It is sold in China, so the socket will be Chinese standard. And here is two USB-C and two USB-A on the front. You can directly fast charge your phone. The USB-C ports are white and the USB-A ports are purple. It has built-in safety barrier to protect the user. The switch is on the back. The rubber pads are on both sides of the button. The model is CD268. It can support up to 2500 watts and 10A. And the USB ports can support input of 100 to 240 volts, 50 or 60 Hz, 1.8A. And we will test the output later on. The length of the power cord is about 1.82 meters. Diameter is about 7 millimeter. Then the size of the power cube is 71 millimeter. Weight is about 474 grams. Use the ChargerLAB Power Z KD002 to test it. We can see the USB-C one supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A, DCB protocols, and QC23, AFC, FCP, SCP, PE2, PD3, PBS fast charging protocols. It also supports 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 12V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 3.25A, and a PBS of 3.3 to 21 volts, 3A. The USB-C 2 is the same as USB-C 1. The USB-A 1 supports QC2, 3, AFC, FCP, SCP, PE2 fast charging protocols. And the USB-A 2 is the same as USB-A 1. Then let's tear it down. Try to open the shell on the front, and the internal module is fixed by screws. We can clearly see two parts. The upper is the AC socket module and the lower is the USB ports. Take out the module. The lower part is the switching power supply powered by black and blue wires. There is a heat sink between two modules wrapped with insulating tape. And there is an isolation plate between the heat sink and the PCB. The primary circuit is covered with a thermal pad. There are lots of silicon adhesives between components, and another thermal pad is in the middle. Clean it up, and we can see the gaps between components, preventing heat accumulation. Only a few components are on the back. And this module adopts the QR architecture to output fixed voltage, and three independent secondary step-down circuits can output different voltages for four USB ports. Next, let's analyze the components inside one by one. The specs of time delay fuse is 3.15A, 250 volts. The surge suppressor is used to suppress the surge current. This is safety X capacitor. The common mode choke is wrapped with insulating tube used to filter out EMI interference. Another common mode choke is wrapped with insulating tape. The input bridge rectifier comes from World WRLSB80M, which adopts LSB package. So it has good heat dissipation performance. A single chip can be used in chargers above 60 volts. Four electrolytic capacitors come from AiShi, 400 volts, 27 microfarad. The I-shaped inductor is protected by insulation tube. The capacitor of master control chip also comes from AiShi, 50 volts, 10 microfarad. The master control chip comes from Southchip SC3023, a high-frequency quasi-resonant flyback PWM controller. It integrates GaN driver and can drive GaN FET. It also integrates X-capacitor discharge and high-voltage start. It provides an adaptive switching frequency foldback function to achieve higher efficiency in the whole loading range. It operates QR and DCM with valley switching for high efficiency. The GaN FET comes from Innosec INN650D260A and adopts DFN8x8 package, 260 milliohm, 650 volts. It has a smaller size and better performance compared to the previous generation. Here is the transformer, and this is the OR1009 optocoupler used to communicate and adjust the output voltage. Here are two Y capacitors. The synchronous rectifier controller comes from Southchip SC3503, which adopts SOT23 package. It compliant with multiple types of MOSFETs, and the output voltage can even down to 0 volts. It also supports both high and low side synchronous rectification. This is a synchronous rectifier marked with D115N10ESL. The solid capacitor is 25 volts, 680 microfarad. The other one is 25 volts, 330 microfarad. The filter inductor is wrapped with insulation tube. This is an 8-bit single-chip MCU with 12-bit ADC used to distribute the output power intelligently. Model is ChipC CSU32M10. All four USB ports are soldered on the small PCB. The PCB of two USB-C ports is the same. The protocol chip and two MOSFETs are on the back. And the step-down inductor and two solid capacitors are on the front. The protocol chip comes from iSmartware SW3516H, used for step-down control and protocol identification. It supports dual interfaces and independent current limit. It also integrates 5-amp step-down converter and can be used in 100-watt chargers. Two MOSFETs from AOS AON7544 are used for synchronous rectification and step-down for USB-C. 30 volts, 5 milliohm. Those two solid capacitors are 25 volts, 220 microfarad. And this is the USB-C receptacle. The step-down circuit of the other two USB-A is in here. The step-down inductor and two solid capacitors are on the front. And the particle chip and three MOSFETs are on the back. The master control chip of the third step-down circuit is also the same iSmartware chip. The two MOSFETs from AOS are also the same. This MOSFET comes from Vanguard VS3622DE, which is used to distribute the power of two USB-A ports and adopts PDFN3333 package, 30 volts, 10 microfarad. Okay, that's all components of this UGREEN power strip or power cube. Compared to the traditional power strip, the biggest feature is the dual 65 watts USB-C ports. So you can get rid of the giant power brick and charge your laptop without a charger. For the best compatibility, it also keeps two USB-A ports for some old devices. Okay, that's all for today's video. Hope you like it. You can click the corners to view other UGREEN products. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us for more power-related content. See you in the next video. Bye!